Hello, and thank you for joining me to talk about how Synology is continuing to enable and enhance collaboration. I'm Dave Russ, a senior technical account manager here at Synology, located at our Seattle office. Collaboration is an important part of our daily lives, especially in the workplace. Over 80% of workers depend on technology for collaboration, and when they use digital tools, they get a 30% productivity boost. During the pandemic, over 550 million workers needed to adjust to working from home and using technology to help them continue to work with their colleagues. During the last year, Synology saw a huge jump in the usage of our software. There was a 70% increase in active Synology Drive users. We also saw a 60% increase in active devices using Synology Chat and a 60% growth in Mail Plus licenses activated. This really highlights the need for software that enables teams to work together while working remotely. So, how do we best collaborate? First, we need the right tools so that we can work individually with other members of our team. But we also need the tools to work together with larger groups of people as well. Synology has continuously built and updated collaboration tools to help teams work together effortlessly. Today, I'm going to discuss our new hybrid cloud solution, HybridShare. Next, I'll dive into the updates we've made to our file management software. Lastly, I'll talk about how we've updated our business communication software. Let's jump into our first section, our hybrid cloud technology. Last year, we introduced HybridShare, an application that allows you to store some information locally on your Synology device and some information up in our cloud service called C2. HybridShare allows you to seamlessly link your local and cloud storage, share and sync files across multiple sites, and keep the data you use most often on your local device so you get the best performance possible. HybridShare now automatically caches files based on when they were last accessed, freeing up space on your device. Don't worry, all of the files that aren't stored locally are stored up in the cloud. If you have specific files and folders that you always want to be available to access quickly, you can permanently pin those files so they're always stored on your local device. We've added features to the C2 storage web portal, giving better visibility into how much storage space is being used for different functions. The revamped dashboard provides information for both HybridShare and for hyperbackup tasks. You'll even have the ability to create, edit, and delete HybridShare folders directly from the web portal. These features come complementary with Synology's advanced plan in C2, which starts at $69.99 per terabyte per year. Unlike some other services, we don't have bandwidth limits or other hidden costs.
Let me show you how HybridShare works. First, we'll be connecting two sites together, one from over here in our US office, and another in Japan. In the DSM interface for our devices, we can see that we have a HybridShare folder set up that is mounted on both sides. Let's open up FileStation to quickly share some project files. I'm uploading some videos and pictures that we took when recording these sessions, plus some scripts and slides. Once they finish uploading, they will be available on any device with the mounted HybridShare folder. Switching over to our remote device, we can see that the files are available, but haven't been cached locally yet. FileStation is able to quickly generate previews for these pictures. And if these files are regularly used, we can actually pin them to always retain a local copy, in addition to the copy being stored on C2. Now, to start editing these clips, we can start importing these files directly into our editor of choice through SMB, even though the files are not yet fully downloaded, by leveraging the streaming capabilities of HybridShare.
We've got many more updates on the horizon for HybridShare. We'll be implementing HTTP3 to speed up transfer performance between C2 and your Synology devices. For new devices that connect to a HybridShare folder, we're adding a cache warm-up phase, syncing your most recently accessed files to your device first so you can get to work right away. To further enhance collaboration and multi-site deployments, we'll be adding global file locking, so you don't accidentally edit a file that someone else is already using.
HybridShare also works well with Synology Drive, providing a well-integrated file management experience no matter where the files are currently stored, and even presents us an opportunity to help offload some bandwidth and increase overall performance. Let's open up Drive Admin Console, where we can see that in addition to some existing shared folders, we can configure our hybrid share folder as a team folder and have the option to set up file versioning. In the settings, we can configure specific users, such as remote employees, to be able to directly stream files from C2. Now that we've configured that, if we hop over to Alex's system and log into the Synology Drive portal, whenever he is working from outside of the office network, he'll be able to stream files from the hybrid share folder directly from C2. We can see that even though he's downloading a file, there's effectively no network traffic happening on our NAS. All of that is offloaded to C2. This works for both the web portal and the client application. This architecture also accounts for when Alex is in the office, where it'll attempt to stream files from the local host if it's available.
By combining Hybrid Share and Synology Drive, we're removing data silos, allowing you to relieve local bandwidth constraints and more easily synchronize files between remote teams and offices. With that in mind, let's talk more about file management for both on-site and remote users. The key to file management is Synology Drive, our file portal for both individuals and teams. Because your files and file sharing between teams is one of the most important aspects of collaboration, we've spent a lot of development time improving Synology Drive. Drive 3.0, which was introduced earlier this year with DSM 7.0, increased the maximum number of indexed files by 20 times. So now you can index up to 100 million files. In the upcoming 3.1 version, even more users will be able to take advantage of that change, as indexing is now supported for the entire home folder. This update will allow you to access files in Synology Photos with ease. All of these improvements make it easier to manage, share, and access files, and that's the whole point of Synology Drive in the first place. Throughout the pandemic, businesses have needed to rely on more distributed employees and teams. This means more devices, more form factors, and most importantly, a greater need for a cohesive and robust file sharing platform. Synology Drive enables this easily through our multi-platform support. We've improved usability for people working on mobile devices by making key improvements to the share screen. We've also made big advances with the viewer to allow a much cleaner experience when using common office files like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint files. And finally, mobile app users will be able to back up and sync folders between their mobile device and Synology devices.
Here we are in the Synology Drive app. As you can see, it's now easy to find content by file type by clicking on one of the four icons near the top. As you can see, I can browse all the photos in my drive just by clicking the top left icon. In Documents, I can also view my files, as well as those stored in the Collaborating Team folders. Now, I want to share a folder with a client. First, I'll click Files towards the bottom of the screen, then I'll click the three dots next to the folder. Towards the bottom, I'll click Share, and now in the top right, I'll click Public Link. Then I'll create a protection link. Then I can just copy that link and open it up in a web browser. I'll paste that link, and as you can see, you can now preview the folder and the files to make sure it's exactly what you expect before downloading it.
We're proud to announce that in an upcoming update, macOS users will be able to use our on-demand sync feature. Because of this, creatives and other professionals will need less local storage, and they'll be able to take better advantage of the storage available on their network. This is going to make a huge difference, especially for users working with large files.
Setting up a Synology Drive sync task on your macOS device has always been easy. The difference now is that macOS users will be able to use on-demand sync by simply checking a box. Now that files in the home folder can be indexed, users can choose to sync the photo folder within their home folder straight to their computer. After the sync task is set up, you'll see Synology Drive appear in Finder on the sidebar as a file provider. You'll find all of the files from the NAS folders, but with cloud icons, which means they are not consuming local storage yet. When users decide to access and download the files by tapping the file or through the right-click menu, the files will be automatically downloaded on demand and the cloud icons will disappear accordingly. Now, Mac users won't have to worry about running out of local storage while syncing with Synology Drive.
With Drive 3.0, we've introduced features to provide administrators the ability to have more precise control of their environment. For hybrid share users, external file sharing can now leverage C2 storage, allowing files to come directly from the cloud to the intended recipient. Admins will now have the ability to disable external sharing, enforce password policies, and enforce password expiry dates, keeping their environment as safe as possible. Finally, we've redesigned a dashboard to display and audit shared links, allowing admins to keep track of what data is being accessed from outside of their organization. Synology Drive is a great platform for file sharing and syncing, but it would not be complete without Synology Office, allowing for spreadsheets, slides, and document files to be created that can be worked on simultaneously by multiple members of a team. In spreadsheets, you can now use more formulas, easily remove duplicate rows, and split text into columns. In slides, we've added the ability to draw on your screen and use custom font types. And in documents, you can now show text formatted in code blocks, as well as show text as shapes.
Let's see what this looks like in practice. I'll go ahead and open up an Office document, and this is a Sheets document. So this was imported from a .csv file, so all of the data gets clumped together up in the left column. I'll select all of that information and click Data, and select Split Text into Columns. And it's space delimited, and just by clicking space, we can see the information spread out. I'll click OK to make that change permanent. And I noticed that there were duplicate entries in this data. So I'll select it all again, go to Data, and click Remove Duplicates, and we see that there are two duplicate rows. If I click Remove, we remove those two rows. Now I'm going to place those back in so I can show you the unique function. I'll copy and paste our headers, and I'll use equals unique, select all of our data, and as you can see on the right side, we only get the unique data on the right side. Now, I'll note here that we can change our values on the left, and as you can see on the right, those values change as well. We can also sort this information. So let's say I use this sort here, and I want to sort by the amount, and I want to sort in descending order, which is -1. As you can see, the amount does get sorted, and all of the values from the left side remain consistent because we use the unique function. Now let's say I wanted to actually find out how many sales each of the people on the left actually made. I can use the filter function. So I can filter and select all of the data. And then I want to filter by name. So I'll select the name column. And then I'll use equals E2 to designate where I actually want to put in the name when I am filtering. So for instance, let's go ahead and copy and paste Kevin into E2, and we can see all of Kevin's sales for this month. I can do the same thing for Jack, and we can see that Jack only made one sale this month. Now let's look at some of the changes we made to slides. Let's say we need to create a sales deck. We're making it easier to make quick adjustments to touch up your design. For instance, we can borrow this color from our image. And if we have some more technical content that we would like to present, we don't have to settle for it being in plain old text. With the new code block feature, things can be much tidier and appear in a more developer-friendly way. While you're presenting, the new annotations feature enables you to quickly highlight things, making your presentation stronger and more persuasive.
To recap, we've dramatically improved the experience of our mobile app, increased the ability to index files, allowed on-demand sync for macOS users, and so much more. All of this just when it's needed most to keep users connected while we're working remotely. To give you an idea of how you could use Synology Drive, imagine you've got a Synology device set up in your office. You can install Synology Drive Server on that device, then download the Synology Drive app on your Android or iOS phone, and the desktop client on your Windows or macOS device. You can then connect to your Synology and set up a sync task for your data. Next, you could set up a secondary Synology device at another location and use Synology Drive ShareSync to keep all of your files up to date at both locations. The Synology Drive ecosystem makes it very easy to always have the most up-to-date version of your files. Once we've got our files taken care of, we need to think about business communication. That's where Synology Chat and Mail Plus come into the picture. Synology Chat is our instant messaging program, and Mail Plus is Synology's own email platform. Unsurprisingly, with all of the remote work going on, we've seen a big jump in the interest for this software. This year, we saw a 60% increase in Mail Plus licenses activated, along with some of the largest implementations we've seen, including our largest to date of 3,000 user accounts. And as you might expect, this solution supported mostly remote workers. In fact, let's talk a bit more about that deployment. Geneva Doctors Association needed a mail solution to host at their headquarters that was secure, reliable, and simple for its members to use. By the end of our discussions, we set them up with a high availability solution for their main devices running Mail Plus. But we also made sure to provide them with a disaster recovery plan by using snapshot replication to another Synology device. With such a redundant system, Geneva Doctors Association is able to sleep easy knowing that their mail system is both secure and reliable. With so many businesses moving to Mail Plus, we've prioritized updates that make it easier to host your own mail server, migrate from other solutions, and manage our solution. By hosting Mail Plus on a virtual instance of DSM, otherwise known as VDSM, you can increase hardware efficiency and RAM utilization, minimize RPO by using snapshot replication, and minimize RTO via live migration. And you can also isolate Mail Plus to stay as simple and secure as possible. Migrating to Mail Plus is easier than ever. Microsoft Exchange admins can simply import their user's old PST file to get them up and running quickly. With our newest updates, you'll be able to migrate nested labels from Gmail inboxes as well. We've made some great new quality of life improvements for admins. In-app license purchases are now available, eliminating the need for physical copies of codes and allowing admins to more quickly increase licenses to match personnel. We've enabled the ability to set quotas for user mailboxes, with the added ability to send notifications to users who are nearing their limit. We've also enabled the ability to import emails from one user account to another to allow for smooth personnel transfers. Mail Plus users can enjoy an integrated client experience both on the web and through the mobile app. The web client can integrate with your calendar and contacts, allowing you to directly add events to Synology Calendar and sync events to your mobile device. On your mobile device, we're bringing new features to help you compose and reply to emails faster than ever. I hope that you enjoyed learning about some of our new features for Hybrid Share, Synology Drive, and Mail Plus. Now, with Hybrid Share, you'll be able to pin data locally to get great performance. macOS users will now be able to use on-demand sync, and Mail Plus is so much easier to migrate to. Feel free to check out some of our other sessions by clicking on one of these three links. Thank you, and have a great day.